about as decorated a kickboxer as has come into this division in some time, DC. And if we get a kickboxing match tonight, he ain't losing.
He is a championship-level kickboxer, a guy that can stand in the pocket and trade and kick and punch with anyone. He's constantly throwing things. From as close as you can get, he's comfortable throwing leg kicks. He will drive these into your body. But it's the aggressiveness and the ability and willingness to stand in the pocket and trade that makes him truly, truly special. I think that is what separates kickboxers, the high level ones, from everyone else.
He understands distance as well as any striker in this division. Of course, that is a byproduct of a lifetime of repetitions in the kickboxing space. Well, we probably trot out the term well-rounded in modern-day mixed martial arts more than we should, but this fighter certainly fits the bill.
Oh, 110%. He can do everything inside the octagon. Where he is most comfortable is inside of that eight-sided structure where most men are terrified of being. But for this gentleman, he only wants to be there. When you try to wrestle him, he's able to defend takedown. If you dare stand and strike with him, he can knock you out. He's got all the tools necessary to become a UFC champion.
His first martial art, mixed martial arts, and that's not always the case. He believes that he... So here we go with the start of round one. I can tell how excited you are for this matchup. Seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but maybe not.
This is a big-time fight. It feels like a big moment for both of these guys' careers. Who is going to be able to implement their game plan the best in this matchup between these two big-time athletes?
Well, you saw the tail of the tape. He has a reach advantage and made good use of it there with that punch. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the Jones. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Able to check that kick as well.
He loaded up on that right hand too.
Oh, tags him with the left. That is an educated left hand.
Educated left hand. He's throwing it so fast and so crisp.
Anderson gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Another shot lands upstairs.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Trying to establish that jab once again.
It's such a fast leg kick. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. He changes the angle, finds the right spot to land that punch to the head from the clinch. Oh, man, look at that. Picture perfect. Got to the leg, got to his position, got another.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Troy gets up. He is back on the feet here.
As he gets close, he's out of the kicking range. He'll change his stance.
Hard shots landing on both sides here. Just out of range with that left hook. Effective punch there by Anderson. Kick to the body by Short. Well, he's looking for that left hand. Just out of range, though, with it. Nice single collar tie now. Oh, and now he lands the knee. I'm not sure his opponent saw that coming.
Didn't see it coming because he does such a great job of just throwing it. He doesn't have any help when he's going for it.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Great job by him to get the takedown there.
He did a good job of setting up his attacks, secured it, and getting the desired result.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Create a scramble, let's go!
All right, so you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't wanna mess around for too long. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by the Korean Super Bowl. Oh, and he's back up again.
Right hand punch to the clinch.
Both fighters throwing heat now. Oh, combination lands. You want to talk about putting strikes together. Beautiful execution.
And every one of them are landing. He's overwhelming him with different attacks.
Oh, man, that couldn't have felt good. Flush knee lands to the body by the taller fighter. Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Big right hook come, and it's blocked. 20 seconds left. Oh! Oh, he might be out. Final second to round one. Well, he continues to find the openings tonight. Beautiful connection with a punch there. What a round. While we look back at some of the replays from that previous round, DC, a lot of good action for fight fans over those 5 minutes.
I mean, high pace, high intensity, all action first round. Both landed multiple strikes. What a great round of fighting.
You see everything coming. I want you to keep doing that. Bring them close to you.
You ready to fight? You ready?
Second round here.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length, of course, it's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab.
Nice punch here. He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
Oh, collar tie.
Nice punch land. Beautiful body kick land right under the elbow.
Some nice back and forth action here. Oh, an educated jab there. I could watch this dude jab all day.
I mean, he's so light on his feet, and when he pops that jab, it comes right back to his face. He's got to be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab.
Splits the guard, lands the right hand. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may float a right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down on the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's got to be confident that it's going to land, and he's got to really throw his whole entire body into those strikes.
Let me see that hook now.
Head kick. Beautiful strike.
Just over 3 minutes now to go. Looked like it did stun him a little bit.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, Johnson. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Looked like he might have landed there. Instead, a swing and a miss by the Korean Super Bowl.
Left hand punch in the clinch.
So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two. Plucks the shot. Just missed with the left there.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick.
The right hand just misses.
Great punch.
Whiffs on the straight right hand. Tags him with the left. Just out of the range with that right hand.
Oh, nice.
Just misses with the straight right. Well, he misses with the left punch there.
Nice.
Try to establish that jab.
Right hand punch.
All right, so volume uppercuts here on the clinch. That one looked like it really hurt. Better make some adjustments here.
Gotta make some adjustments. You cannot take those shots to the head like that.
Nice job to raise the guard and block another strike there. He doesn't want the ringside position anywhere near this octagon.
He has to understand that at any moment, if this thing goes down into the eye, the referee and the commission will have to stop the fight. Great job being aware, keeping the hands up and blocking, making sure to minimize the damage to that already cut eye.
Anderson's attempt there is blocked by the opponent. Oh, he gets the takedown late in the round here. That's a way to leave an impression on the judges, and big picture, I think, could set him up for future success in the next round. Control now. I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
A lot of top pressure being applied here. Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground-and-pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you've got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop.
You've got to defend. But you can see him now starting to gain posture, and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
All right, we now take a look back at some of the highlights from that last round, DC. A lot for the replay guys to choose from.
I mean, these guys are going to be very busy trying to find what replay to show you guys. Lands on both sides of the octagon. Both guys fought great. What a phenomenal round.
All right, DC, here we go with our next round, and we'll see if he can pick up where he left off. High volume of strikes landed in the previous round.
High volume of strikes landed. He was able to be accurate, but also very, very active in his approach to the start of this fight.
Oh, nice straight punch there. Must be nice to have a reach advantage like this, DC.
Very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient, not just with his...
Whoa! Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. He's done. He's done.
Well, missed on that one. All right, so he connects with another punch there, kind of targeting that cut, I think.
I mean, when you get a cut on your opponent and you see it and it's pouring blood, you continue to attack it. Every time you land, you can see that it splits it a little bit more. Great job finding that weakness and really taking advantage of it. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Elbow by Anderson. And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands.
Nice strike.
Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home. Overhand block there by Anderson. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, lighten up his opponent left and right. Choi gets absolutely punished by that head kick.
Ooh, what a punch.
Punch is blocked. Wow. Anderson's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Both fighters exchange in the pocket here. Oh, and there's the double leg takedown for him. Beautiful entry there. Well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Well, he's in a compromising spot here, DC. You got to figure out a way to get back to your feet. All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here.
Beautiful punch.
Oh, tripling up on the jab. Well played. And he continues to work the body here. Good series of strikes by him there.
Great job of mixing it up, staying active, keeping busy, doing great work.
Swing and a miss with that punch by Anderson.
Let's go. Keep pushing forward.
That right hand hurt him a little bit. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Wow, that right punch has been the money weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there.
If his opponent does not...
Whoa!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. We'll finish his fight. Big body kick lands.
Oh, tagged him with that right hand. What a strike that was.
What a strike that he is landing over and over again. His opponent will need to make some adjustments.
You need the takedown.
Beautiful leg kick thrown.
Oh, he continues to land a high number of strikes in this round.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish.
Oh! Huge right hand!
He is getting lit up right now,
Dean steps in!
Wow! What a fight!
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. He's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 4 minutes, 31 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Korean Super Boy, Doo Ho Choi.
Well, we congratulate him on a